Hey everybody and welcome back to another Python scripting tutorial. In this video we're going to be looking at how to change the layout for our operator, but this can also be applied for panels and things. So let's go ahead and look at the finished result. So when we press N and then go down to the text tool add-on, I'm going to be using this example, but you can use any kind of operator that you want. Now when we click this button, it should bring up the dialog box and it looks okay, but we can improve this and make it look a lot better. For example, we can add a box and also this extrude amount here. We only want this to be visible when the extrude is enabled. If it's not enabled, there's no point showing it, so I'm going to get rid of that as well. And we can look at a few other different things that will hopefully make it look a lot better. So first, let's go ahead and load up our scripting layout. If you have one, go ahead and load it up. If you don't have one, just scroll through here and find the scripting workspace. And then you can go through here and arrange the layout. We don't need any of this. And I'm also going to enable word wrap. And there we go. So go ahead and load up your script. If you don't have a script to load, I'll make sure to leave a link in the blog so you can download the script that we're using. So just go ahead and open it up. So now we have everything we need. I'm going to press N to open up the sidebar here, go down to the text tool and then click add text. So as I mentioned, we want to change a few things on this operator. So I'm just going to scroll down here and find the operator, which is this text tool operator here. And if you've not seen the video on how to create this pop-up dialog box, there'll be a link up here. Go ahead and check it out. So inside this operator, we have a couple of things. We have the custom properties. We've also defined the invoke method, so when we press this button, it pops up. And then down here, we define what's going to be executed when this button is pressed. So we can now define something else. If we go to the beginning of a new line and then just press tab to indent it, and then I'm going to type def draw, open and close parentheses, add a colon. Then in between the parentheses, I'm going to type self, comma, context. I'm just going to hit enter. So now we can create a reference. I'm going to type layout equals self.layout. Now we can add things like text and buttons and properties, anything that you want to add, we can do that now. So let's type layout.label, open and close parentheses. Then within here, I'm going to type text equals, then quotation twice. Then inside the quotations, we can just add some text. Something like that. Then if we run the script just to update everything, now if we press this button, we can see we just have this sample text. But you might be wondering where everything's gone. That's because we're now using this section to define how it's laid out. So now we can arrange things and make it look much better. Let's go ahead and add all these things back in. So the way to do that, I'm going to hit enter again. I'm going to type layout.prop, open and close parentheses. Then inside here, I'm going to type self, comma, and then quotation twice. And then in between here, we just want to type the name of the reference. So for example, we want to bring all of these back in. So let's start with the text. So I'm going to copy this, paste this in just because I'm lazy, run the script and then press add text. And now we can see we have this enter text field. So if we type words, then hit okay, we should add some words into the scene. So now we know that works. I'm just going to copy and paste all these in. So let's copy this one. Just need to paste this in a few more times, something like that. And then I'm going to copy the scale, paste it, rotation, center, extrude, and extrude amount. So now if we run script and then just see how it looks. So it's pretty much the same as before. It's a little bit different, but it's essentially the same because we've not changed anything. We're using the default layout. There's a few things that I want to achieve in this video. Hopefully it's not going to take too long and hopefully you guys find it helpful. So let's go ahead and just jump right in. So we can see by default we're using layout, and the way layouts work, it'll just add everything to a new line. Then if we want to put something side by side, for example, let's put the text and the scale, let's put them side by side. We're going to be using a row. So let's type row equals layout.row. Open and close parentheses. And then all we need to do is just copy this, and we want the text and the scale to be on the same row. So let's paste this in here. Then if we run script, now we can see enter text and the scale share the same row. So that would be for the row. I'm going to change this back now because I don't want these two to be on the same row. Let's change this back to layout for now. So yeah, we have things like row, we have columns, we have a whole bunch of stuff. So I'll try and link to some API documentation. So hopefully you guys can check out all the different types. So yeah, I want to create a box here for these values. So let's do that. After the scale, I'm going to type box equals layout.box, open and close parentheses. And anything that we want to add inside this box, we just need to copy this and paste this in. Hit run script just to update it, then hit this button. And we can now see these three checkboxes and this extrude value is inside this other box. The next thing I want to do is align these two on a row. As we mentioned before with rows, it's a little bit different since it's within a box. So I'm just going to show you how to do that. So we have the rotation boolean, the center boolean, and the extrude boolean. That's these three here. So after the center boolean, I'm just going to add a bit of space. So now I'm going to type row equals box.row, open and close parentheses. And you can see the difference here is the box. So it's saying it's still within a box, but I want you to be a row. So let's copy this and paste this in. Now when we run script and then add the text, we can see it now shares the same line. And then the next thing we can do real quick is remove this extrude amount unless this box is active. So let's go ahead and do that. So we can see this is our extrude checkbox. So right after this, we're going to be using an if statement, which we kind of took a look at in one of the previous videos. If you want to check out any of the previous videos, there's a playlist up here. So what we want to do is say, if the extrude value is checked, then do something. We want to show this extrude amount. If it's not active, then you don't have to do anything. I'm going to type if self.extrude, because that's the name of the boolean. You can see up here, extrude. If self.extrude is equal to, so we add two equal signs here. Then I'm going to type true with a capital T and then add a colon. Then all we need to do is just go to the beginning here, press tab just to indent this. So now when we run script, click this button, now we don't see anything. Then when we check this box, now we can change the extrude amount. So I think by doing this, it makes it look a lot better. If we're not using the extrude amount, then there's no point seeing it, I guess. The next thing I want to do is pretty much do the same thing with these two. So create more if statements, but instead of showing a value, I'm just going to show some text. So it's pretty much the same way that we did this. So I'm going to go back to the rotation, make some space. Then here, I'm just going to type box.label, open and close parentheses. Inside here, I'm going to type text equals quotation quotation. Then in between here, I'm going to type orientation z up, something like that. And if we want, we can also add an icon. So I'm going to add a comma and then type icon equals. Then if we hit apostrophe twice, then in between here, we can type the name of the icon. So let's go ahead and find an icon. I'm going to press Control T and then change this to the icon viewer. By the way, if you don't have this, you will need to go to edit, then to preferences, just go to add-ons and then type viewer. And we can see we have the development icon viewer. Just check this and then you will be able to see this from now on. So I think I'll use this one. I'm just going to click it and we can see now we have this copied, and then down here I can just paste this in. Then I'm going to press Control T just to hide this. If we run script, get an error. That's because I added a full stop rather than a comma, like an idiot. So now we run script, we can see it all works fine. Then if we add the text, we can see down here it's added the text by default. So we just need to create that if statement. If self.rotation is equal to true, then we want to show this. So I'm going to press tab just to indent this, run the script. And now we don't see that text, but when we click this to activate it, we do. So now we can see it adds the text to the bottom, which doesn't look too good, especially because it pushes everything else out the way. So like we did with the extrude, I'm just going to make this share the same line. So just above here, I'm going to type row equals box.row, then copy the row, paste it here and here. So now if we run script, that should share the same line, and it does. So we can also continue this and add some text when it's not active. So let's go back here. I'm going to use an else if statement. So at the end of here, I'm just going to hit enter, then press the left arrow key just so we're no longer indented. Then I'm going to type elif, which is short, I guess, for else if. So else if self.rotation is equal to false, then add a colon. And then we could just copy this text here. Copy this, paste it in here. Then the orientation is no longer Z up, it will actually be default. And then the icon, we want to change this icon, so let's probably use these arrows. And then paste this in. So let's run script and let's see what we have. So now we can see the orientation is default, and then if we wanted to, we can click this and now it's pointing up. I'm probably going to relabel these because they don't really make sense, but hopefully you guys get the idea. The center origin, I'm going to do the same thing for this. So we can say alignment to the center or alignment default, something like that. Also add an icon, and we can see the extrude amount works fine. So yeah, I'm probably going to do the same thing for the origin, add some text and maybe an icon, but it's the exact same process as we did here. So that works fine, but let's add some space between the scale and this checkbox. So to do that, so let's go back up here. So right after this scale, I'm going to type layout.separator, open and close parentheses, and then in between here, we can define the factor. Factor equals, so by default, it's going to be 0. Let's give this a factor of 1. Now we can see that there's a little bit of a gap here. If you can't notice it, let's just change this to 10, something dramatic. There we go. So you can see there's a big gap now. But yeah, hopefully you guys get the idea. There's a lot more that we could dive into with this layout stuff. I mean, we could get even more complex than this, but just wanted to share with you a few improvements, such as adding text so the user knows what's happening when you press the buttons. Also, this extrude value, we can get rid of stuff that we don't need until we need it. So if you want to use this script, I'll make sure to leave a link in the blogs. Go ahead and check that out. But hopefully you found this helpful. If you did, be sure to give this video a like. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.